All right, so do you want to know how you can make your body a fat burning machine? I'll show you how to do that. Stay until the end of this video. So welcome back mga kwentuhan. So if this is your first time in my channel, so please make sure to hit that subscribe button and don't forget to hit that notification bell as well if you want it to be healthy and fit. Usapang fasted workout tayo. So fasted training yan. Yan yung isang mga video na pinramis ko na gagawin ko sa inyo. And that's what we're going to discuss in this particular video. Alright, so before I move on and go ahead with that, let's discuss first the difference between yung fasted state and yung fed state, no? So usually our body process food within 4 to 6 hours depende kung gaano karami yung kinain natin from the last meal that we have taken. So for example, your last meal, say lunchtime, you took it at about mga 12 in the afternoon. So the fed from 4 hours up until 6 hours of the last meal that you have taken, then that's your fed state. So after 6 hours, that's where the fasted state comes in, no? So it doesn't necessarily mean also na itong i-discuss natin is what we call intermittent fasting. So iba yan siya, ibang topic yon. So it's nothing very similar dito sa i-discuss ko sa inyo na fasted workout or fasted training rather. Okay, so let's start. So how does the body process the food that we take? So ano ba muna ang nangyayari every time na kumain tayo ng pagkain? How does the body process it and how long does the body process it? So ito yung nangyayari dyan mga kakwentuhan. So ganito yan siya, no? So first things first, after we eat, ang gagawin ng katawan natin is for it to process the food, so our body will start to release insulin para mapanormalize yung blood sugar level. So our body next, after it releases the insulin for our body to normalize the blood sugar level, our body then now will absorb the proteins and fats na makukuha dun sa pagkain kinain natin. And next na gagawin would be yung carbohydrates that are in the body will be processed as sugar or glucose. And then itong glucose na to will be transported through the blood in the bloodstream, and that in turn will become the energy na kailangan for us to be able to move and do our daily activities. So that happens within the 4 to 6 hours time frame, depende kung gaano karami yung kinain natin. Okay? So that's happening, or that is what is happening within the timeline. So that's what we call fed state, no? So ano naman nangyayari during the fasted state? So after the 6 hours na the body processed the food, next thing that's gonna happen is this. So we'll now enter the fasted state. Our body will start to release glucagon. So glucagon is needed for our body to normal the sugar levels, no? So yung blood sugar levels para ma-normalize siya, yung katawan natin magre-release ng glucagon, right? So next thing that's gonna happen after the body releases the glucagon, it will now start to break down the fatty acids. So anong mangyayari dyan sa yung fatty acids na yan? So itong mga fatty acids na to, this in turn will be converted into ketone bodies. So ito yung usually naririnig nyo pag ang pinag-uusapan is yung keto diet, no? But it doesn't necessarily mean that our body will enter ketosis every time we're on a fasted state, no? So ibang usapan yun. This time, we're just merely discussing what's happening when we enter yung fasted state. So again, once we enter the fasted state, yung body will release glucagon to normalize the blood sugar levels. Next is our body will start to break down yung free fatty acids, which will be converted into ketone bodies that will be needed for it to be converted into energy. Now, insulin levels is very much needed, or insulin chemicals sa pinoproduce ng katawan is very much important in processing yung free fatty acids. So if you could remember earlier, I mentioned that during the fed state, our body will use insulin to normalize blood sugar levels. When we are in a fasted state, glucagon is the one thing that is being used to normalize insulin level or blood sugar levels. Dahil yung insulin this time around, yan naman siya yung gagamitin for our body to break down yung free fatty acids that will be needed to convert into energy, which is yung ketones, no? So that's why if you keep on eating every 4 to 6 hours, so yung insulin na chemical na pinoproduce ng katawan, instead na gagamitin ng katawan natin to break down yung fats, hindi niya magagamit yun dun siya. So gagamitin niya kasi yung para ma-normalize yung insulin, yung sugar levels mo. So in a way, hindi natin na ma-maximize yung fat burning process or mechanism na naturally created ng katawan natin. Especially nowadays that food is readily available, so nalilimit yung pag maximize ng katawan natin na gamitin yung fat burning mechanism. Okay, so yan yung difference between yung fed state and yung fasted state, and that's what's happening. It is very essential that you need to understand before I discuss yung ano yung benefits ng fasted training or fasted workout. Okay? So now, how does fasted training becomes more beneficial and makes the fat burning faster? On a normal day, if we are not doing any particular training, so and if we practice yung fasted state, technically our body will still burn fat to convert into energy, no? So on a fasted training, we just merely are maximizing the effort of our body to burn more fat. Ang training requires more energy versus the normal day wherein there's no training at all. Tama ba? So that's why every time you do fasted training workout, you get to burn more fat faster. Dahil, since matagal yung fasted state, or yung from the last time na kumain ka, so papasok ka ngayon sa fasted state, so your body will start to process yung free fatty acids, and then it will be converted to energy. Now, there were studies that were made in the United States between two group of individuals or group of people. Yung isang group ng tao, they had a carbohydrates food that they took before they went into training, and the other group of people naman was in a fasted state. So it showed in that study that 20 to 30% of the people that are in the fasted state was able to burn fat faster or burn more fat than the normal people who are not in the fasted state. Dahil nga dun sa idea na when you are in training or doing weighted training or any particular training, may just be a normal cardio workout or weight resistance training, your body has to burn more fats because it requires more energy. Yeah, nakukuha niyo ba? So, one more thing that was found out in that particular study is that in terms of glucose, glucose is yung sugar na ginagamit din ng katawan in terms of energy, what was identified as well is that there were no big difference, or in fact, it was just the same. Yung glucose level ng dalawang group of people na yon are just the same. Ang nagkaiba lang is that yung tinatawag na intramyocellular lipids. Ano ba tong intramyocellular lipids? So pasensya na, medyo magiging technical ako para mas maintindihan nyo on how the body process fats para makatulong sa inyo in fat loss or weight loss na gusto nyo makuha, no? So yung ano ba yung intramyocellular lipids? Simply put, ito yung mga very tiny mini fats that can be found sa mga muscles natin, no? Eh paano yan, Alvin? Eh, ayoko naman wala naman ako nakikitang medyo malalaking fats in terms sa mga muscles ko. Ang gusto kong paliitin is yung belly ko. Okay, so ganito kasi yan, mga kakwentuhan. So papaliwanag ko sa inyo, no? So anong purpose nito? Based on this study, it was found out that in a normal situation or in a normal average person, usually there is about 18% na availability ng mga intramyocellular lipids na to sa mga muscles natin, yung mga maliliit na fats na to. At ano itong mga maliliit na fats na to? During a fasted state, ito yung biniburn ng katawan natin that is being used as energy. Okay? So ito yan siya. Dito kinukuha ng katawan natin yung energy. So based on studies, yung 18% na yon na intramyocellular lipids that were found inside the muscles, nag-drop down yan that from 18% to 6%. So ibig sabihin, between these two group of individuals, doon kinukuha ng katawan natin yung fats to convert into energy. So how does that help you in terms of overall fat reduction? So dahil ngayon natanggal na ng katawan natin yung fats sa muscles, which is something very important to protect the muscle fibers as well. So syempre ngayon yung katawan natin kailangan i-replace yon, right? Yung katawan natin ngayon kailangan i-replace yung mga intramyocellular lipids na yan that was converted into energy. So ngayon, saan kukunin ng katawan natin yan? So syempre, sa other parts of the body wherein fats are also visible and available. So na yan siya. So syempre, dito na sa may abdominal areas na. So yung, yun nga, yung mga taba dyan sa may mga chan at sa mga love handles natin. So in a normal process, so that's how it works in terms of why it's beneficial to do a fasted training or a fasted cardio in a fasted state versus kakain ka muna before you started your training or your workout. So that is the big difference in terms of why it's more helpful and beneficial for you if you started workout during a fasted state. Okay, so ngayon, so naintindihan nyo na ako ano ang paano na nakakatulong yung fasted training sa pagpapabilis ng fat burning process. So now I'll give you 4 or 5 benefits that you can use out from this fasted training. Aside from the normal, which is yung fat burning process, no? One thing that can be beneficial during a fasted training and long-term benefits of it is, of course, syempre, it aids you, you reduce the risk of heart-related diseases. So yan, nakakatulong yan siya, no? Second is, it reduces the risk of you being obese. Third also, it reduces the risk of you having diabetes. Dahil ang katawan natin is not dependent anymore in terms of sugar or glucose. So that's why these are the benefits long term of being in a fasted state or fasted training. Now, just a precautionary measure, if this is the first time that you will be doing yung fasted training or fasted workout and your body is usually accustomed in eating first before a workout or a training, I recommend that you start it with just a cardio muna, cardio exercises, dahil baka maka-experience kayo ng what do you call this, yung dizziness or pagkahilo, or you may also sometimes feel weak if you are going to immediately jump into a fasted weight resistance training, at baka mas maramdaman mo mas wala kang energy. But as your body adapts to its new how do I call it? It's new eating habit, then your body will also adapt in terms of producing the energy when it's much needed. So, yan yan siya, no? So, just a precautionary measure before you start your fasted training. Alright? So, these are the benefits and precautions that you need to consider before you start your fasted training. Okay. So hopefully sana nakatulong ito sa inyo mga kakwentuhan. So if it did, please help me share these videos to your friend and families. Okay? So kita ulit tayo mga kakwentuhan bukas. Bye-bye.